Welcome to the module of What Works Clearinghouse Single Case Design Standards training focused on determining research ratings for findings from studies that are eligible for review under the Single Case Design Standards. You can access all the resources mentioned in this module through the WWC website, whatworks.ed.gov. This module describes the WWC standards for reviewing findings from single case design studies and explains how the WWC applies the standards to determine the research rating of a study finding. After completing this module, you will be able to describe the WWC standards for assessing single case design studies that are eligible for review, and you will be able to apply those standards to a single case design study. Before we discuss the WWC's current standards for recognizing single case design studies under version 5.0 of the handbook, it is important to recognize several important changes that occurred between versions 4.1 and 5.0 of the handbook. The WWC has added an exception to the requirement for the number of data points within a phase required for a finding to be eligible for a rating of meets WWC standards without reservation. Designs that contain shorter phases with zero within phase variance are still potentially eligible for their findings to receive the highest possible research rating, which will be discussed later in the training. The WWC has also added an additional step in the review process for some single case designs whose findings are potentially eligible to receive a research rating of meets WWC standards without reservations. This step is intended to assess the internal validity of some designs in a fashion similar to processes that are embedded in visual analysis. Finally, the requirements for combination designs and designs with more cases or phases than the minimum required to meet the WWC standards have been relaxed to allow for more high-quality designs to be eligible to receive the highest possible WWC research rating. Now that we have highlighted the recent major changes to how the WWC reviews single case design studies, we will now provide an in-depth discussion of the process for reviewing evidence from single case design studies. This slide and the next slide provide an overview of the process for reviewing single case designs. We have reproduced elements of the figure found on page 106 of the handbook. First, as we discussed in the last module, reviewers need to ensure that the outcome measure of interest meets outcome requirements, including the inter-assessor agreement requirement, as well as determining that there is no evidence of a confound. If a study passes the first step, the reviewer will then move on to assess whether the data are available in graphical or tabular format. If the data have been made available by the authors, the reviewer must then determine whether the independent variable was systematically manipulated by the researcher. If the study meets requirements for the manipulation of the independent variable, the reviewer will then determine if there is evidence of any residual treatment effects. However, it is important to note that this step may not be relevant for many studies reviewed by the WWC. If reviewers, in coordination with a content expert, do not believe that residual treatment effects are likely, reviewers will then move on to the design assessment stage. At this stage, reviewers will determine if the authors designed their studies with sufficient opportunities to demonstrate the intervention effect, as well as whether the authors gathered enough data points in each phase. Some designs will have additional design-specific requirements. For findings that meet all requirements to meet WWC standards with reservations, the review process ends here. Findings that are potentially eligible to meet WWC standards without reservations, however, will move on to the limited risk of bias stage, which is a new stage introduced in the version 5.0 handbook. At this limited risk of bias stage, reviewers will determine whether findings receive a research rating of meets WWC standards without reservations, or a rating of meets WWC standards with reservations. If at any point in the process, a study finding fails to meet the requirements of one of these steps and is only eligible to receive a research rating of does not meet WWC standards, the review ends. If there is information missing that could potentially change the rating of the finding, reviewers should make note of the missing information for an author query and proceed to the next step in the review process. The remaining chapters in this module will describe these steps in more detail and help you check what you've learned so far.